So, I started to work on my car again. Mixed up a little bit of mechanics fuel. It's over there on the bench. And pulled the valve cover off. This is kind of mid-job. I was going to replace the valve stem seals for the intake valves. And when I pulled off the valve cover, man, it is nasty in there. Oh. Now, mind you, this is not like, you know, another episode of a drunk guy fingering a tranny. But there is some gunk. But here in the back is what really caught my attention. Was this buildup right there. Oh, look at that. I'm taking a nasty dump. So I'm wondering if maybe this is contributing to my smoking issue with the engine. But since I've already started this process, I'm going to go ahead and continue with it. You know, man, this poor baby, she's been rode hard and put back wet. But this is just one side. This is the driver's side valve cover, well, driver's side head. Gonna go ahead and pull the other one off when I get to it, and we'll see. I'm suspecting it's gonna match, but thought I'd just capture it for the club to see. I'm back. So I scraped some of the junk out, and it definitely looks like the oil feedback holes, or whatever you want to call those, for the oil to bleed back in into the pan, were covered, both in the front and the rear. So I went to my closet, and I pulled out a coat hanger and took it apart. I left the curl on one end, so we'll stick it down in the hole and see what she thinks. Yeah, we got a dollar for every time we said that. Alright, here. Ooh, definitely not going free. Gotta give it that Roto-Rooter treatment. Maybe there's something in there that keeps that from happening. Because it's stopping after, oh, only about that much. So maybe it makes a turn somewhere, one of the oil galleys or something. Although, twisting it, yuck. Oh well, so not getting very far with the front one. Let's move to the rear and see what happens. Ha! Same thing. We had a dollar for every time. Oh, that's definitely going in. I'll run that through a few times. There we go. Come on, get in there. Yeah. A lot of you may not agree with my music selection for this video, but it happened to be what was on. Come on, get a hold. There we go. Well, the rear one definitely went deeper than the front one. Although, with the way that head hangs over, I'm fairly surprised. Now that I look at it, that hole's got to go somewhere else. All right, well, just a little bit of an update. You know, do some cleaning and make a decision on whether or not to do the valve seals now or start it up and see what happens. So I just pulled the passenger side off, and that was actually worse than the driver's side. There was already oil pooled up in there, and the minute I pulled the valve cover off, it started running down the exhaust manifold and pulling in with the spark plugs. You can see that down here. So I'm going to have to get me some cleanup going on. Definitely a sledge-ridden engine. Ugh. But, you know, every little bit helps, I think. So. Okay, so, gotten as far as getting the plug wires back in place. Spark plug wires. I put a bunch of fuel in the carburetor. Well, I tried to get it down into the bowl of the carburetor, but we all know how that goes. So a good amount went down into the throttle body. Got everything hooked back up. So I'm thinking, let's go ahead and fire this thing over. Won't really know about the smoke until the morning. But thought it was worth trying to fire over now, just to get some time on the motor. Ooh. All right. So she's purring like a kitten. It's too dark to know whether or not any of the work really did any good, but I'm gambling that it did. The whole idea of getting those oil galleys cleared out. Not really sure how that couldn't help. She doesn't sound like she's messing at all, so I got the wires back on in the correct order. Oh, gotta love that smell, though. Ah, there's a little bit of smoke. I expected there to be something. Lord knows on this side, as the oil flowed over onto the exhaust manifold, it was going to do something. So, I'll let it run a little bit. We'll see how she is in the morning. You can see it all right. Check that out right there. Oh, yeah. Well, I'm not sure if this video is going to capture it too well, but she's definitely smoking. It's bad enough I can't hang out in the garage. I got the window, the back door open. It's flowing outside. I knew she was going to smoke, but kind of underestimated this one. Yeah. A little rough. So, gonna give it some time to kind of burn off. Thank God the door is closed and the wife won't come out, because we all know what happens then. At any rate, just an update.